Yo Brollies, what's up? So DeepCool has recently released their budget line of CPU coolers featuring the AG and LE series, which essentially has the same thermal and noise performance characteristics of their respective premium brothers, the AK and LS series, at least on paper. And as per my observation, the differences are mainly in terms of the packaging and design, and a little bit on the technical specifications. And to help you decide, we're going to quickly compare their specifications, and then we'll do an unboxing experience of the new DeepCool AG400, AG620, and LE500. By the way, as part of our still ongoing 50k subs milestone celebration, together with DeepCool, we're giving away one DeepCool ST500 ARGB GPU support bracket, so watch the entire video to learn more. With that being said, let's get into it. Now we're gonna break this down into four main criteria: packaging, design, mounting, and technical specifications. I don't have the AK and LS series, so we're just gonna base it from their product page, but like I said earlier, later on we're going to unbox some of the new AG and LS series CPU coolers. With that being said, let's start with the AG and AK400. So in terms of packaging, both the AG400 and AK400 seem to share the same packaging design. And the CPU coolers themselves also look almost exactly the same, except for the top part where the AK400 also features a shroud. By the way, the AG400 has an RGB fan variant, while the AK400 only comes in a non-RGB fan variant. In terms of mounting, they have the same mounting for the AMD platform, but differ when it comes to the Intel platform, with the AG400 using plastic backplates. The shape of the mounting for the CPU block is also slightly different, but should provide the same mounting experience. Finally, in terms of the technical specifications, as you can see, they are not far from each other, with the AG400 being slightly smaller and lighter, but has a faster fan, higher fan airflow, and better fan air pressure in return for a slightly noisier fan. So at least on paper, it looks like the AG400 is slightly better in terms of performance potential while being cheaper. Next, we have the AG620 and AK620. In terms of the packaging, they are slightly different, with the AK620 being a little bit bigger and featuring a brown box with an outer sleeve. And in terms of the design of the coolers themselves, like the 400 series, they also look almost the same, with the AK620 also having a shroud on top and a slightly different looking fan. And when it comes to mounting, unlike the 400 series, the 600 series seems to share the same exact mounting accessories, even for the Intel platform. The only difference I can see here is the packaging for the thermal compound and an additionally included screwdriver for the AK620. In terms of the technical specifications, the AG620 and AK620 are actually almost identical to each other, with the AG620 being a little bit lighter due to the lack of additional shroud. But they do have the same number of heat pipes and possibly share the same heatsink, basing from its dimensions, and almost have the same fan configuration, with the AG620 having a slightly lower fan airflow and fan air pressure, but at these levels, I honestly feel like it is negligible, even their noise levels. And last but not the least, we have the LE500 and LS520, which are their latest AIO liquid CPU coolers. In terms of the packaging, at least in terms of the exterior, they look exactly the same. And in terms of their design, they also almost look exactly the same, except for the CPU block, with the LS520 having a more premium look and more RGB lighting zones. Another key difference that I noticed here is in terms of the tubes. The LS520 has proper sleeving, while the cheaper LE500 features a bare rubber tube. And in terms of mounting, they are slightly different, with the LS520 having more screws and accessories, especially for the addressable RGB lighting and customizable logo on the CPU block. But in terms of technical specifications, it looks like they share the same radiator, judging by the dimensions, and it seems like they also share the same radiator fans, at least for the performance side of things, with exactly the same specifications. But I was able to verify that the LEDs on these fans are static 6-color LEDs compared to the FC120 addressable RGB fans of the LS520. The tubes are slightly longer on the LE500, but the pump of the LS520 is significantly more powerful and has more extensive addressable RGB lighting with a customizable CPU block. Overall, I honestly feel like most of the differences and cost cutting was done on the packaging and aesthetic side of things, while maintaining the same performance potential of the more premium AK and LS series CPU coolers. Now, as promised, let's do a quick unboxing experience for the latest DeepCool AG400, AG620, and LE500 CPU coolers. Right here, we have the packaging for the DeepCool AG400, and this is the LED variant. This is not addressable RGB though, and just features static 6-color LEDs. At the back of the box, we have the specifications, but we've already seen that earlier, so let's just see what comes in the package. Inside the box, we have the mounting accessories, the user manual, and the DeepCool AG400 itself, nicely protected by a couple of styrofoams. The user manual has easy-to-understand instructions and illustrations written in different languages. In terms of the mounting accessories, as I've pointed out earlier, we have plastic backplates for the Intel platform, a couple for different sockets, and the metal bracket for the AMD platform. We also have the corresponding screws and standoffs here, and one of the key differences, which is instead of a typical syringe-like packaging, we just have a sachet for a thermal compound. And finally, we have the DeepCool AG400 itself. The heatsink and its fins still essentially feature the same checkered board design language of the AK400, just without the additional shroud on top. We also have the LED fan here that features 500 to 2000 RPM in terms of speed, 75.89 CFM in terms of airflow, and 2.53 mm of aqua in terms of air pressure. In terms of the illumination, it features a static 6-color LED. Overall, it is still a pretty decent looking CPU cooler with performance specifications that match, if not even better, than the AK400 for a cheaper price tag. Next, we have the packaging for the new DeepCool AG620 dual tower CPU cooler. In front, we have an image preview, and then at the back, we have the specifications. Again, we've seen this already earlier, so let's crack this open. Inside the box, the first thing you'll notice is the accessory box, followed by the DeepCool AG620 itself, also nicely protected by a couple of styrofoams. Inside the accessory box, we have the user manual, also with easy-to-understand instructions and illustrations written in various languages. We also have a fan speeder, the adjustable metal backplate for the Intel platform, the mounting bracket for Intel with its corresponding screws, another mounting bracket for AMD also with its screws, and some capping screws also for Intel. And like the AG400, we only have a sachet for the thermal compound. Now, at first look and touch, it really does resemble the AK620, also featuring a dual tower design. Again, just without the additional fancy shroud on the top of the heatsink. It features the same iconic checkered board design, and just really shares the same exact heatsink with exactly the same dimensions and numbers of heat pipes. Even the mounting brackets and accessories are the same. The fans are not exactly the same, but the specifications, at least for the performance side of things, are nearly identical. I also appreciate the fact that this is quite versatile in terms of fan mounting options, allowing for flexible allowance for RAM compatibility. Overall, if you're good with how the AG620 looks, especially in comparison with the more premium AK620, then I think this is a better option in terms of the price-to-performance ratio, since they essentially share the same performance potential, just different in terms of design. Like I said earlier, we're giving away one DeepCool ST500 ARGB GPU support bracket, and all you have to do to join is like and share this video, of course subscribe if you haven't already, and comment down below which of these CPU coolers do you think has the best value. Check the description below for more information. And last but not the least, we have the new DeepCool LE500AIO. As I've pointed out earlier, the packaging looks quite similar to the LS520 with an outer white sleeve and a brown main box. At the back, we have the specifications that again, we've already seen earlier. Inside the box, we have the egg tray-like packaging that houses and protects the two radiator fans, the mounting accessories, the user manual, and the LE500AIO CPU cooler itself. The user manual offers the same instructions and illustrations. Then we have the plastic adjustable backplate for the Intel platform, a fan speeder, the mounting bracket for the AMD platform and its screws, the mounting bracket for the Intel platform and its standoffs, the capping screws for Intel, and the fan and radiator screws. The radiator fans for the LE500 feature a static 6-color LED illumination, which obviously is non-addressable, but at least has decent specifications for the performance side of things, with speed running up to 2250 RPM, with a high 85.85 airflow rate and 3.27mm of aqua for the air pressure. The CPU block is quite basic, but at least the tube connectors are rotatable for any possible mounting orientation. However, it is very jarring that the tube doesn't have additional protection or sleeving, which is obviously where most of the cost cutting was made for this cooler. It also doesn't have any additional fittings. It is really flexible, I'd give them that, but honestly, I feel like extra protection is a must here. The radiator, on the other hand, looks quite typical with the anti-leak technology from DeepCool. Overall, it is still a pretty decent looking AIO. In fact, it reminds me of those old AIO coolers when tube sleeving is not a thing yet. I just hope that this is durable enough to withstand not only the installation process, but also the day-to-day usage. Honestly, I'm very impressed that most of the cost cutting made is just about the packaging, design, and aesthetic side of things, and all these CPU coolers maintain the performance specifications of their more premium brothers. Maybe except for the LE500AIO with that bare tube and less powerful pump, but the AG400 and the AG620 looks very formidable given their relatively less expensive price tags in relation to the potentially same performance. And there you have it guys, obviously this is just a comparison and unboxing experience video, so take everything with a grain of salt and do further research before pulling the trigger. I'll try to use the CPU coolers in our future builds, so stay tuned. Huge thanks to DeepCool for sending this in, you can get this using the links below. Thank you for watching, subscribe if you like this, and see you next time. Have a great day guys, you're awesome.